Hello and welcome back. Marine here for Lawn Fun with a new Magic Picture Changer card showcasing the new A Bug Deal stamp set. I used a bunch of stamp and die sets to create this little garden scene, so make sure to check the list of supplies below the video for more details. I first started by cutting a Strathmore Bristol panel, and I'm going to use scattered straw, dried marigold and spiced marmalade distress inks to create the sky. I chose these colors because I knew that the leaves would be khaki green and I thought that everything would coordinate nicely. So I covered half of the panel with scattered straw. Next I added dried marigold on the other half and blended both sides together. And finally, I added a little bit of spiced marmalade at the very top to add contrast and this way create an extra touch of brightness in the middle of the panel. Of course, and like always, I added water drops that I dried using a paper towel. And I created more drops by mixing dried marigold and spiced marmalade distress inks with water. Now I'm going to create the Magic Picture Changer element. So I started by cutting two pieces of Strathmore Bristol cardstock, a long panel for the pocket element, and a small panel for the moving piece. I wanted the pull tab to be on the right side of my card, so this is why both of the dies are oriented towards the right. I used the pencil to mark the window spots, and next I'm going to stamp the images. On the long panel, I stamp the branch and the chrysalis, and I stamp it twice to get a nice impression using jet black ink. On the small panel, the chrysalis turns into a butterfly. I stamp the branch again and also add a tiny sentiment, "Hey Love Bug." I mask those tiny images and use the same inks as before to color both panels. I removed the masking paper and colored the images using my alcohol markers. When the coloring was done, I taped the dies on the panels, making sure to align the windows with the branches, and I sent everything to my die-cutting machine. Next, I applied a double-sided tape on the thin tabs of the pocket piece, front and back, and I folded the panel in half as well as the tabs. And I also rubbed the flaps using a bone folder. This will help the mechanism to work nicely. I removed the backing paper from the back of the thin tabs and folded those tabs to attach them. Next, I put the moving piece inside of the pocket panel through the slit. And I put each of those flaps into a small slit like so. Next, I applied a lot of powder on the flaps and along the tabs. This will help the mechanism to work nicely. I lined up the moving piece between the tabs. I removed the backing paper and folded the main panel to close the pocket. Next, I took the frame die from the Magic Picture Changer add-on set and placed it on my background panel, making sure to put the notch on the right side. I applied thin double-sided tape on the four edges of the frame and attached it on the pocket, making sure one more time to line up the notch with the tab. Now I'm going to assemble the background. I have my images on the left. I have a card base and also the remaining pieces of the background, but I will only use the thin strip. I first attach the strip on the card base and then the Magic Picture Changer pocket right below the strip using double-sided tape. For the bottom of my card, I wanted to create a garden, so I started by cutting a cloud border that I will use as bushes, and also a wavy border that will be a soil border. I used Vintage Photo and Grand Espresso Distress Inks to color the wavy border. Vintage Photo all over the border first, and then I added Grand Espresso at the top to bring depth. For the bushes, I used Peel Paint and Forest Moss Distress Inks. Like the other border, I applied the lightest color, Peel Paint, on the entire border, and then I added the dark color, Forest Moss, for more contrast. And to bring more texture to those two borders, I splattered drops of the same inks I used to color those elements. Next, I applied foam tape below the Magic Picture Changer pocket, and I first attached the bushes. Every cute garden needs a white fence, so I cut one out of wood grain cardstock using the picket fence border die set, and I applied a tiny little bit of Hickory Smoke Distress Ink on top of it to make it less new and clean. I attached this picket fence on the bushes using double-sided tape. I applied one more layer of foam tape at the bottom of the panel, and then I stuck the dirt border. And of course, I trimmed everything, making sure not to cut the pull tab. Now to the coloring part. The images were stamped using jet black ink and cut using the coordinating dies. Like I said at the beginning of this video, I used a bunch of supplies to create this cute little scene, so make sure to check the description box if you need more details. Thank you. When the coloring was done, I attached everything using liquid glue and glue dots. And I will also stamp my sentiment, happy birthday, on the signed image. The card is almost done, but I need to attach the pull tab handle. It was cut out of raspberry cardstock and I'm sticking it using double-sided tape. And I have flowers on my card, so like always, I'm adding white nouveau drops in the center of those flowers and also on the mushrooms. And that's it, all done. Look how cute they are, all gathered to celebrate the birth of the butterfly. By the way, which one is your favorite? Mine is the roly-poly on the tree trunk. He's just super cute with his teeny tiny little legs. Well, I hope that you like this new interactive card and I wish you an amazing day. Bye!